Hare Krishna. Problems may get stuck inside us, but we don't have to get stuck inside them. Whenever we face some problems in our life, they irritate us, perplex us, anger us, and sometimes overwhelm us. And somehow problems seem to come with some kind of glue by which they get stuck inside us. Our mind starts becoming like a one-track sound player or a video player. It just keeps going on and on that problem. Why did this happen? Why did this person do like this? Why did I do like that? And the problem is stuck inside us. We just not be able to get that problem out. We may want to focus on something else, but it might just be very, very difficult. The problem just seems to stay stuck inside us. Now, if we consciously decide, I won't think about this problem. It's like if something is stuck and we try to pull it out. Sometimes, say, we sit on some seat and somebody has put some glue over there. So then if we get up, then our clothes might get ripped over there. So like that, when we try to unfix or pull that problem away, turn away from that problem, the problem just stays stuck to us and we just can't get it out of our head. It can become very exasperating. The problem is stays stuck inside us and we just can't apply, like we might apply some physical force to pull out something which is physically stuck, but we can't put our hand inside our head and pull that thought of the problem out of us. So what do we do at that time? Here we need to understand that although we can't change the presence of that problem in our consciousness, we can still change the focus of our consciousness. That means if we consider our consciousness to be like a broad sense of awareness where our conscious energy from us is flowing in different directions. So now because this tab is open in our head, that problem's thoughts will stay there. But if we try to fight it also, we're still thinking about it, saying that I won't think about it. Instead, we start thinking of something bigger. We start thinking of other things. So the problem may stay stuck inside us, but we don't have to stay stuck inside it. That means we don't have to be constantly thinking about it and dwelling on it. Instead, we can think of something bigger, something better, something sweeter. And the best such reality is Krishna himself. He's the all-attractive Lord. Just thinking about him is so satisfying. He is the all-wise Lord. Thinking about him is illuminating. And when we learn to think about him, then we don't get stuck inside the problem. And if we keep thinking about him, the problem will stop burdening us so much. It may still stay stuck, but it won't irritate us so much. It's like in our house, if somebody has stuck something, some graffiti somebody has written and then stuck, and they're not able to remove it from the wall, we may feel annoyed. But if we keep thinking about that graffiti, we'll get more and more infuriated. But if we go on with our life, then gradually we won't be troubled so much. And maybe by rain, by sun, whatever, by other things, the graffiti might just get dimmed and erased. So similarly, if we direct our consciousness towards Krishna, then gradually we will find that the problem won't trouble us so much. And for this, directing our consciousness towards Krishna, we need to habitually fix our mind in Krishna. When we do that, regularly fix the mind in Krishna, then it enables us to direct our consciousness towards him constructively. Krishna assures this in the Bhagavad Gita 18.58, when he says, Machittaha sarva durgani matprasadat tarishyasi atha chetvam ahankaran nashroshyasi vinamshyasi. He says, if you become conscious of me, you will pass over all obstacles by my grace. But if you don't become conscious of me, that means you think you can only deal with this problem, you can get it out of your consciousness by your own efforts, then vinamushasi, you will perish. Don't have that ego thinking, I can deal with this. Just focus on Krishna and Krishna will help us to deal with the problem. Thank you. Hare Krishna.